Hey everyone, I'm sure you all know about the chip shortage and how new hardware is hoarded by crypto miners. So what do you do if you want to play Wordo, but your computer just isn't quite up to spec? Maybe your computer can't run a web browser with JavaScript or a 32-bit operating system. Today, I'm going to review two Wordle games made for Windows 3.1, and then an incredible 7 different Wordle games for DOS, starting with the appropriately named Windle from dialup.net. This is maybe the gold standard for Wordle on Windows 3.1, and I'm saying that mainly because of the look and feel of the UI. Don't the 3D beveled edges just scream early Windows? This game was written in Delphi, which is a Pascal-ish language, but it's native code calling native Windows APIs, so it feels right at home in Windows 3.1. If you want to try it out but you don't have Windows, it does run under Wine and even Arca OS, and you can play it in your browser at the Internet Archive. Next up, we have WinQuest, made by LuigiThirty. Right off the bat, I have a little bit of a problem. The zip file contains a whopping 38 files, and even the zip file, at 1.9 megabytes, does not fit on a floppy disk. And without networking, I had to do this the hard way. It might be big, but look at all the extra stuff you get. There's a 7-segment display from Minesweeper, configurable keyboard layouts, score tracking, even audio. Under the covers, it was written in Visual Basic 3 using a dictionary stored as a Microsoft Access database, which is a rather interesting choice. The included corpus.mdb is almost 800 kilobytes, even though storing 15,000 uncompressed words should take less than 100k. Unfortunately, this game does have the double count bug where if you guess two of a letter, but there's one of that letter in the answer, it'll highlight both letters. Anyways, if you have the hard disk space to spare, definitely try out WinQuest and all its bells and whistles. So, that covers the Windows 3.1 Wordles. Moving on, for those of you who prefer to stay in DOS, we have a whopping 7 different Wordle implementations. The first of these is WORDOSle, and it's only 52k. No color display? No problem. There's even a monochrome option. The behavior of the highlighting isn't quite correct. It does have the same double counting bug that WinQuest has. Next is WORDOS, a Wordle implementation written entirely in assembler. It's even slimmer than WORDOSle, being only 40k in size. And amazingly, this game even runs on the original IBM PC, which has a 4.77 MHz Intel 8088 and a monochrome display. It does have the double count bug, however, which is a shame. The next Wordle is also called WORDOS, but with a hyphen, like MS-DOS. Written in C, it's slightly bigger at 68k including the dictionary. For whatever reason, the dictionary seems to lack a lot of words that I tried, but on the plus side, it does in fact handle repeated letters correctly. Number four is WORDOS, WORDLOS. It's written in assembly and comes as a single 65K COM file. I like the display of used letters at the bottom, and overall, it looks very similar to WORDOS. However, this also has a double count bug where it tells you that there's two of a letter, but there's only one. This next one is a simpler implementation. DOSdl is a tiny 44K COM file that feels very bare bones. There are no graphics, no colors, and the guess results are displayed with a very simple X, blank, or caret. The simplicity must have given the author a little more time to implement things correctly, as I've confirmed that this Wordle does not have the double count bug that I've been checking for. Next is a bit of a weird one, Laworde, built on a fork of ZZT. ZZT was a 1991 adventure game that also let you create your own games, and it also happened to be the first game created by Tim Sweeney. That's right, the man who made ZZT then grew his company into a gaming juggernaut by creating such games as Unreal Tournament and Fortnite. Obviously, Wordle is not an adventure game, but if you try hard enough, anything is possible, I guess. Selecting letters is done with the arrow keys, and it actually runs quite slowly, even though I have a 486. But still, kudos to the creator for the unconventional implementation and for not having the double count bug. Finally, for those wanting nice graphics without all the bloated Windows stuff, we have DOSWord. Now, this is some next-gen stuff, and I recommend copying it to your hard disk first because loading it from a floppy does take a while. For that disk space, you get probably the nicest graphics out of the DOSWordles I've shown you. When you win, you're rewarded with a very nice bouncy animation, almost as good as the bouncing solitaire cards. Cool animations aside, it is unfortunately afflicted by the double count bug as well, but clearly that's something many Wordle clones missed the mark on. So that's a total of 9 Wordles that I could find for Windows 3.1 and DOS, and it's great to see that writing software for computers of that era isn't totally a lost art. If you're interested in trying these out, links are in the description below, and if there are any other DOS or Windows 3.1 Wordles out there, please let me know in the comments.